I'm Will Morley, pastor of First Baptist Church of Sparks, Nevada. I've got another word from Will, little incidences in the life of a Baptist pastor. We have now canceled church for 7 Sundays. Many of our members are asking and wondering when we are going to resume Sunday morning worship services. In leading this church, other than theology, which is my domain, I rarely make any decision without the input of our leadership, mostly through our church council. In this instance, I spoke to the chairman of our deacons, our educational director, who is also a deacon, and then our church administrator, as well as her assistant. We all agreed it was time to have a worship service. Coronavirus is declining. None of us knew anyone that had had it. And we thought if we adhere to the strict distancing guidelines, wear masks, use hand sanitizers when you come and leave the church, take the temperature of those entering the building, and limit the sanctuary to 50% capacity, then the reward would be worth the risk, especially if we practice those 5 recommendations. Certainly, if you are elderly, have an underlying medical problem, or are worried and or concerned, when then we encourage you to stay home. So, concerning civil disobedience, as in breaking the law, the question is concerning the coronavirus epidemic. Should a church have worship service when the government says no? The answer is not as easy as you might think. The Bible says in Titus chapter 3, verse 1 and 2, "Remind them to be subject to rulers and authorities and to obey." Romans 13, 1 through 7 says, "Let every soul be subject to the governing authorities, for there is no authority except from God, and the authorities that exist are appointed by God. Therefore, whoever resists the authority resists the ordinance of God." And then 1 Peter chapter 2, verses 13 through 16. "Therefore, submit yourselves to every ordinance of man for the Lord's sake, whether to the king as supreme or to governors as to those who are sent by him for the punishment of evildoers and for the praise of those who do good." Now, I agree those are very, very strong passages of Scripture that would teach us to obey our governor and do what he asks us to do and not have worship services. But it seems to me you can only take that argument where the Bible says we are to obey those that rule over us so far. If that is absolute, then there would never have been an American Revolution, and thus no America, no Constitution. If that is absolute, then we would still have slavery, segregation, and second-class citizens. If that were absolute, then women would still not have the right to vote. And by the way, all three of those landmark movements were led by devout Christians disobeying the law and disobeying those that ruled over them. I do think peaceful resistance and civil disobedience has a place in our society for Christians. What the governor has asked us to do for 8 weeks, we have done. But then, when he allows restaurants to open at 50% capacity, allows barbershops, hair salons, liquor stores, marijuana stores, and we see Walmart, Costco, Home Depot, grocery stores, and garden centers filled with wall-to-wall people, and yet he keeps churches shuttered, that seems to me to be unjust and unfair. In the scheme of things, this is very small, and we could wait another couple of weeks. We could go along to get along. But if you don't stand up for little things at the time they are happening, then why would I think you would stand up for big things? Are we going to wait until they outlaw or ban the Bible or forbid preaching on certain sins from the Bible, or we can't preach Jesus is the only way to heaven because that offends people? Or what if they use this instance to shut down churches to see if we would comply, and in the future they do it again over something else? And then in the Bible, we have Peter and John disobeying those in authority. They said we ought to obey God rather than men, and they went ahead and disobeyed those in authority. Daniel knew the king, that King Nebuchadnezzar had passed a law concerning worship. And the Bible says that Daniel knew what the king had done. And he went home and he opened his windows and he got down on his knees and he prayed three times that day, basically thumbing his nose at the king. And then there's the two midwives, Shipra and Pua, who totally disobeyed the king's orders and spared the newborn baby boys. And there's Rahab, who disobeyed the king of Jericho. And there are other scriptures that concern the Apostle Paul and others who disobeyed those in authority. So there you have it. Scriptures and examples that teach to obey and disobey. So what would you do? To make up your mind, let me read one more scripture. The Bible says in Hebrews 10, 24 and 25, "And let us consider one another in order to stir up love and good works, not forsaking the assembling of ourselves together, as is the manner of some, but exhorting one another, and so much the more as you see the day approaching." This was commanded for Christians to worship at a time when persecution was strong and being forbidden. That is Christian worship. One of our most cherished freedoms is freedom of religion, freedom to worship, freedom to come and go as we please, freedom to peaceful assembly. And we know that our government, whenever it can, is trying and has suppressed the freedom of religion. And that is always in the back of our minds. I and the leadership of First Baptist Church like to think we are not doing wrong, because what the governor is doing in singling out churches, whether intentionally or not, he is doing it. And so we have a right to peacefully disagree. So this Sunday, we're going to have just one worship service at First Baptist Church to protest those in authority and their decision to keep churches shut down. Now, if the authorities come and tell us we can't assemble, then we will go home quietly. We will obey. So there you have it. Thank you for listening to another word from Will. I hope to see you next time, either here in my office or from jail. Amen. God bless.